YouTube. What is crack-a-lackin'? It is Scott from Semi-Pro here, aka Danny Tanner Swiffer, aka Tupac is from Harlem, sorry Bay Area people. And today we are talking about the Golden State Warriors. But before we get into the video, I want to say one thing. If you are new to the channel, give this video a watch, and if you like what you see, subscribe to the channel because there is much more where this came from. We post dope daily sports content on this channel, NBA, NFL, MLB, college sports, anything sports related you want, we have here. Anyways, I have bad news for non-Warriors NBA fans. The Golden State dynasty is not over. After years of watching this team make it to the NBA Finals and dominate the NBA, it was a breath of fresh air to watch them struggle in 2019, to be quite honest. It made a team that at one time seemed invincible, human again. No Curry, no Klay, no KD, and a Draymond who was utterly useless without those guys on the floor, and Juan Toscano-Anderson. This Warriors team just wasn't anywhere near what they had been in the past, and as a result, went from a clear title favorite to one of the worst teams in the entire NBA. After this drop-off, people have started to count them out. When you hear people talk about the teams that will be contending for the next 2 to 3 years, you hear the Lakers, you hear the Clippers, you hear the Bucks, you hear the Celtics, but in 2020, rarely do people mention the Warriors. It is almost as if just because everybody else is ready to move on from the dynasty, they think the Warriors are also ready to move on. But that is not the case. Let me explain why. It starts with Steve Kerr. Is Steve Kerr the best X's and O's coach in the NBA? Hell no. But through his experience playing for the two greatest coaches to ever do it, he figured out how to establish a damn good culture for the guys he has on his roster. He may look broken down now, but I am telling you, just wait until Klay and Curry return. This culture is gonna look like it didn't miss a single beat. These guys buy in and they know what they are doing and they have championship pedigree. Curry is obviously the best player on this team, and one of the best point guards of all time. His injury history, though, finally caught up with him this season, but at age 32, he should still have a couple of really, really good seasons left in him. He doesn't rely on athleticism and can use his craftiness and obviously the best shot of all time to get his for the coming years. When he is on the floor, this team is automatically dangerous. But he can't do it all by himself, and that is where Klay comes in. He is obviously going to be coming off an injury next season, but he has been able to remain largely healthy throughout his career, and he's just 30 years old. There seems to be this sentiment that these guys are aging, but at 32 and 30, they're really still in their primes. Klay and Steph on the floor together is a nightmare for opposing defenses, and people underestimate how great they are after just not seeing it for a while. I see a ton of recency bias when people try to evaluate this team for the coming seasons. Hold up, wait a minute, timeout. Vibe check. Let's take a second, let's appreciate everything we have. Right now, times can seem tough, but if you are watching this video, chances are you are blessed with a lot in your life right now, so let's just take a second to appreciate that. Okay, Draymond is a guy who has become a popular player to hate on this team. People say he isn't good anymore, people say he's annoying, he doesn't fit, yada yada. Reality is, a player like Draymond is worth more than what the stat sheet shows. He is a great off-ball player who does countless things that don't show up in the box score, and not to mention his presence is vital to the culture they have built in the Bay Area. He is also a fresh 30 years old, and even though it appears as if he has been declining, this guy is still a necessity for them and a more than viable third option. Speaking of third options, Andrew Wiggins still looms on this roster. If they keep him, which I think they should, I think he can be a great piece and asset at the small forward position. That pressure of him needing to be a top two option is out the window when this team is healthy, and he can just do what he does best in a lesser role. He is a guy who can average 15 to 20 for them when everybody is healthy and contribute in a variety of ways. His trade market though is wide open, but I just don't see a guy who the Warriors could get taking into account Wiggins' cap hit that would be a better fit. But if you look at it, a core of Curry, Klay, Draymond, and Wiggins isn't too far off from the core that helped them go 73-9. Obviously, there are fringe pieces that need to fall into place, and they aren't getting any younger, but writing this core off would just be silly. Just last season, these guys were looking like the best team in the NBA still. Granted, this was with KD, but I still believe this core has what it takes. Another guy who I really like as a contributor for this team next season is Marquese Chriss. Chriss kind of looked like a bust prior to joining the team this season, but since he has found a nice groove for himself. He averages about a block and a steal per game and is a guy who could fit really nicely into the Warriors small ball scheme. He is an athletic freak who can play the 4 or the 5. Now, there are two huge X factors here. Let's start with one Warriors fans love to discuss, Giannis. There have been heavy rumors around the Warriors acquiring him. This would have to happen in 2021, presumably, and obviously, if Giannis comes, the dynasty surely isn't dead, but it unfortunately might have to include moving on from Klay, barring a massive cap spike, which granted did happen for them so they could land KD. Anything is possible there, but Giannis coming on would absolutely lengthen this dynasty. The other X factor is this year's draft pick, which is going to be pretty high. A lot of people have them taking James Wiseman. I love this pick and think it's their best option. I think he fits in well and could do a lot in a lesser role right off the bat. He would almost certainly be the best center the Warriors have ran with during this era right out of the gate. He could really change up their inside presence, and he can also work that mid-range game a bit, and I'm sure he will develop a three-point shot there. This would also allow Chris to come off the bench where he could wreak havoc. A starting five of Curry, Klay, Wiggins, Dre, and Wiseman is one of the best in the entire NBA, and you can't sleep on that lineup at all. The Warriors still have some stuff to figure out, but I have seen what this core is capable of, and it is greatness. I refuse to write them off just yet. Of course, they could come back and just not be the same after injury, that's definitely a chance, but their playstyle should age like fine wine. People are super quick to write this team off, but be careful, you might just see them in the finals next season. This dynasty is far from over. If you've made it this far in the video, do us a favor and leave a like on this video, it really does help us out a lot, and in the comments section, drop your top 3 rappers of all time. Not your favorites, not the best from this era. I'm talking your top 3 rappers to ever do it. I'll start off with mine. I'll go ahead and pin that comment and start a chain beneath that. Again, if you're new to the channel, please consider subscribing. We post a lot of really awesome stuff every single day. Thank you for watching and have a blessed rest of your day.